Hey, this is Retired Geek Woman with Stardew Valley 1.5, Retired Slow Play, part number 28. We're going to take up where we left off, which was ready for day number 4 of spring in year number 2. Oh boy, we are up to 7,400 gold, which is not in the ballpark or universe of how much we need. Checking the weather for tomorrow, it's going to be a sunny day. We're waiting for a rainy day to check on something. And the tips, living off the land, eels need to be caught in the ocean in the spring or in the fall during rainy days. So, rainy days. Got to keep that in my brain. Rainy days. Oh, look at that. Willie gave us a chowder recipe. So again, working on those relationships pays off in all kinds of ways. So we're going to grab our items that we need to get our morning chores done. I really like my little beehive sitting there making honey with the little flower growing. Hello, Key Cat. Checking the hay. It's not going to matter here soon, but for now, it's important we keep that hay going. Let's check our babies. Tyra's a month old and got half a star. And of course, we know that Lucy's 5 stars. I love my Lucy. We got Daisy, who's a month old now. And we got Thumper, who's a month old. And we've got our Daffy, who I forgot how old he is and I forgot to check. So we're going to, now that we've got 2 ducks, they're going to either give us 2 eggs on one day and none on the other, or they're going to be giving us an egg every other day, which is my hope. But it's kind of hard to, I know if I was a mathematician, I would have figured that out. And I would have put the duck egg in so that it would have hatched on the right day. So you're getting a duck egg every day. But I refuse to drive myself crazy and figure that kind of thing out. So we are going to say hello to our beloved Clara and Nanny, who is 2 months old with 2 stars. Out of 5, and get some goat milk. And we got a graced quality large goat milk, so that's a very good thing. So she's loving us even more. We're gonna grab this mushroom while we're here. And again, I was looking at back behind to see if it had dropped any mushroom seeds, and it still hasn't. It's like, oh, what am I gonna do? I hate to cut down that mushroom tree, but I don't know what my options are. I don't know what else to do. I mean, I can, the ones down here, they're growing mushroom trees all over the place. Look at all that. Look at the seeds. I've got multiple mushroom trees growing right now. So the other one up above isn't doing that. It's not dropping. There's nothing around it. There's space behind it against the wall there, against the rock wall. I mean, what it's telling me is it just doesn't want to grow there. That's what I'm thinking, because I had really wanted to grow that so that it would drop a seed behind it and put the tree right next to Grandpa's shrine. I thought that would look really cool, but it doesn't look like that's going to happen. So I'm still debating on what to do, but we got to get it figured out, because I really need to get these fences built so I can get my animals out in the sunshine while there's still sunshine to be had. I don't know if I read this somewhere or if someone was just kind of guesstimating. I'm pretty sure that they're happier if they can get out and get fresh grass. It keeps their relationships higher, I think. But yeah, I could be wrong about that. I could be hoping that. I could be thinking that. I could be wishful thinking that. So there's that weird capsule still. And while I was doing what I was doing, I made the decision. Goodbye. Well, it gave us a secret note. Goodbye. Here's what happens when you chop down a mushroom tree. You get mushrooms. I got 6 mushrooms. So what does our note say? Someone's diary. Oh, it's talking about, there's only a few older bachelors in town. There's one, Harvey. This is talking about the male bachelors in town. So I think that's very interesting. It gives you a little tip about the male bachelors in town that are available. And Harvey's the only one that's not like a kid. The other ones are kids, and I'm not a kid. If I was playing this game and I was in my 20s or even my 30s, I might consider marrying a kid that rides a skateboard, but I'm not. You know, I'm a retired senior. So I really wish that we had more options. Harvey's fine, he's wonderful. But we, you know, I have no other options for a senior male. So, you know, he's it. And I wish we had more, but, you know, maybe Concerned Ape will see this and go, you know what, you're right, we really do need some more seniors in town, male and female. So get on that concern date. I'm just kidding. All right, so let's go down here and have a quick chit chat with our handy carpenter Robin and see if we can go ahead and move that chicken coop now. Again, construct buildings, click the move icon, and then you click, it says choose a location. Really, you're choosing the building. So I'm gonna pick that building and see it turns into a, like a, you know, little dashes. And now that building will fit right there. And I think that will be just fine. And if I'm not mistaken, that's exactly where I had them on my my planning map that I'm using, which is my 11-year farm. So that's what we're going to go with for now. And I'm really happy about that. And we need to get busy making money. We do need to build the fenced-in area for our animals so they can get out and get some fresh grass. And I'm kind of walking along, I'm also foraging. Might as well. Hey, do you remember that we had gotten a secret note about something that was supposed to be hidden back here? And I thought they said that it just said it was hidden back behind the community center. So I just start hacking away with my various tools, and I can't see what I'm doing. I'm kind of stuck right there. So nothing was happening, but it's supposed to be something behind the community center. So I thought, well, let's try the hoe. So I just kind of moved a tiny little bit and just kind of hoed everything along the way here. And still nothing so far, but maybe I missed it. I wasn't right against the community center. Maybe this will get it this time, whatever it is. And I don't know what it is. So anyway, I love those secret messages because they really do give you something different to do. Oh, look! A Junimo statue. Isn't that cool? It's a garden art for your farm. So that's what that secret note was about. There was something hidden there. While I was here, I thought, you know what? Let's go ahead and clear up all this fiber. Really, it's clearing the weeds, but we're getting the fiber for it, and man, do we need that. That's an important resource for us. And eventually, I'm going to actually grow my own fiber because I use so much of it. So that's okay. We can do it. So let's come on down here and let's check. Today is Kent's birthday. For girls only, I need a flounder. I almost accepted this. I kept thinking, do I have a flounder? I'm not sure if I have one or not. I wasn't sure. I probably should have said sure. And let's go talk to Pierre while we're here because he's one of those that we don't have any relationship with at all. We don't have even a single star. I thought, you know what? Let's give him a let's give him a flower, whatever that is. Let's see if that worked. Do we have at least one star? We do. The only person we don't know is Kent, and it's Kent's birthday. So maybe we should get a birthday present for Kent. So we can guess at it, or if we want to be precise, we can check the wiki. The wiki will tell you exactly what people like, and it will tell you what they don't like, so that you don't make the mistakes I've made. Or you can just keep guessing at it. It's all a matter of preference and your play style. And I wanted to get that relationship going, so I am going to double check. I hate it when they're trying to come out when you're trying to go in. Come on. Yeah, I'm sort of friends with your son. Birthday gift. Oh, good. He didn't hate it. So that's a good thing. So let's see if we got a heart out of it. And we do. Look at that. He's not even at the bottom of our list anymore. Where is he? He's way up here. So that means that he has closer to the next heart than the people below him. So I thought that was pretty cool. So we need to kind of keep on that this year. We really don't want to miss any birthdays. And if we can figure out what their loved gift is, gifts, I should say, usually there's three or four, and usually they're a cooked food of some sort. Then we can make those relationships grow a lot faster. So I felt pretty good about my decision to go ahead and get rid of that mushroom tree. I've been laboring that for however long it's been there, which is most of a game year. I've been laboring over that. It's like, oh my gosh, seriously. I just can't believe that It took me that long to make up my mind, but you know, it's kind of a big decision. I mean, mushroom trees, I mean, you can see in a little over a year of the game, I've got three. So if you care about them at all, and if you want them on your property at all, it matters. So that's what I had been thinking. So it's time to start working on the fences, and I use hardwood fences. That's one reason I've been collecting all that hardwood, is so that I can place fences. Now, you need fences and gates is what you need. And I make a horrendous mistake right here. So what I thought was a gate is actually a fence. And I made 40 iron fences I did not need. And I didn't notice it. So I was like, okay, I'm going to go ahead and stick this over any old place. It doesn't matter. Later when we're going to make our, we're going to eventually have fields that will remain fields forever. And once I get that laid out and we're there in the game, we'll figure out where to put that really cool statue to kind of honor those guys. So I'm going to go ahead and get started on the fences. As I had mentioned, I'm using an 11-year farm as kind of a pattern, but at the same time, the 11-year farm has a deluxe barn and a deluxe coop up in this area, which each have 12 animals, so there's 24 animals that I have fenced in. Right now, we don't have anything remotely close to that. So I kind of start off here with a much smaller area because of what's really needed right now. So I kind of shot myself in the foot when I did it. You'll see I'll have to go back and fix it because it just is not working very well. It's not working the way that I had intended it to, which really sucks when you consider how difficult getting hardwood is. And then I realized right here, these are not gates. These are iron fences. So I don't know what I'm going to do with those. I may just put them away and come up with a use for them later. But I was like, what the heck? Iron fence. Ugh. I just can't believe I did that. That was totally not my intention. It's like, okay, I see this is not working here. Because I wanted to put a gate in. Because it's really easy when you're working like this to fence yourself in and not be able to get out. So you have to knock them down. So it's like, okay. No! No! Wood! That's when I realized it right there. It's like, oh my gosh, I used up all that iron ore for no stupid reason. I've got a ton of wood. Oh, I can't believe I did that. Anyway, we make mistakes. We make mistakes. What are you going to do? So anyway, I want to make sure that I made a few gates so that I don't get, you know, fence myself in and I'm not able to get out. There's only one gate, so it doesn't matter what kind of fence you have. It's all the same gate. So basically, clicking on it just makes a gate right there, wherever you clicked. And that's what I just did. To open the gate, you right-click it. And then you can close it, you know, right click it again to close it. But I'm looking at my pattern here going, okay, this isn't making sense to me and I shouldn't have continued, but I did. Ended up with a really small space here. And it doesn't look right. Even right now, it doesn't look right to me. Things like, this isn't right. But that's okay. We're going to start off with a little area and we'll fix it later. But this is how you build your fences. And that's what we're going to do so our sweet pets can come out and get some fresh air. Yeah, I went way too far over there. And I want to make sure that we can get to Grandpa's shrine. I don't want to ruin that. And, of course, we're going to have trees in the way. And as I go along, I just kind of knock the trees down that are in my way. So it's a very exciting time because we've been waiting to do this. We've been waiting to build our fences out and kind of arrange our farm or design our farm. In the beginning, we really didn't have a whole lot of choice because we were working on so many other things. And now we have the time and the resources, in theory, to go ahead and get our place for our animals. I know a lot of people don't do this. They don't do fresh grass for their animals, and I'm sure that their animals are properly fed and happy as campers, but I like mine to be out and about and be able to roam and get their own fresh grass. And you can, we'll show you how we plant that grass, how we get grass seed, and how we plant it soon. So for now, we're just kind of clearing this area so we have room to do the things that we are going to do. And getting late, it's already almost 9 p.m. and it's like, oh my gosh, this is taking forever. I really don't like having them wait this long, but at the same time, they're fine. They're happy inside, and they've got we've got their hay on their bench that they can keep eating off of. And the coop has the auto feeder. The coop is the deluxe coop. Then hopefully when we get 25,000 extra gold laying around, we will upgrade our barn. When you upgrade the barn, it stays on the outside, it stays the same. It will still have the same floor plan. What am I saying? Footprint. The style of the barn on the outside will change slightly, as did the chicken coop. But then the inside, you will see, you'll have a big 12, a bench for 12 pieces of hay. You'll have there's an auto feeding feature. And then you won't have to go and put hay on the bench or anything like that. And there's other things that we'll be adding later on, but we're going to leave those as a surprise as we go along. So again, I just ran out of hardwood fencing. You can see how much it takes, especially when you mess up like I'm going to mess up here. But that's okay. We can deal. Yeah, let's see what we got here. I still had hardwood on me. Yeah, let's make some more. What do we got? 25 more. So I'm not sure how much far that's going to take us. I got resources from cleaning up the farm area. I got a geode out of it too. Look at that. Yeah, let's make some more. I'm not sure how many more to make. We are going to have to make some more trips down south there and go into the super secret forest and get more hardwood because we're going to need it. Eventually, we're probably going to have, I've done this before, I'm going to have a second deluxe barn later on that we're going to put elsewhere, and it needs fences too. So, oh, I love my beautiful hardwood fences. So what you can see I'm doing here is I'm trying to make two different sections for my animals to go into. So I'll plant grass in both of them. When the grass gets low on one side, then I can redirect them to the other little field that will have full grass, and then that way I'm alternating them out and letting grass regrow in the area that they just ate. So that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. And I'm looking at it thinking, man, this just doesn't look right, and I don't want to lock myself out. And I need to make sure they can get in too. So here I'm doing okay. Oh, it's getting late. It's already midnight. It's like, holy cow, really? Oh my gosh. And this area that you see me walk around, that's not a mistake. That's part of the mistake I made was making this sections way too small. And that's okay. It'll get fixed. But you can see there's two different places that they can go, and I close one and can open the other. Do you see how that can happen? Now I want to make sure I close that when I walk out, because nothing worse than your cows getting out. And if they don't make it back to the coop or the barn before, I think they go to bed at like 5 o'clock. If they don't make it back by a certain time, they sleep out in the field. And I don't think that's a good thing for them. I don't think they like that. So anyway, thus ends day 4 of spring in year number 2. Oh, we only got 756 gold, but that's okay. That's okay. It'll be all right. So it's day number 5 of spring in our second year. I'm going to check that weather report, and it's going to be sunny again tomorrow. Okay. And we've got mail. We got 50 wood from Robin. Well, thank you, dear. We've sure paid her an awful lot of money, so we appreciate the free wood. And let's see, putting away those iron fences that I didn't intend to make. Ugh, gracious. Get rid of these seeds. I should be making snacks, but I'm not. Just kind of putting everything away a little bit. I'm getting busy here. We got to do our chores first. Let's see. Probably ought to get my bail or my things that I need. I'm really carrying around way too much stuff. I'm still trying to decide what jams and jellies. We really don't have summer items. We don't have a whole lot. We should have some fruits though. Extra. Yeah, let's do plums. So we're going to do plum jelly instead of, this time we had blackberry, we're going to do plum next time. Yeah, let's get that kitty watered. I don't even know if we got him yesterday. I'm not sure. Yeah, let's see. We're going to put that over there. That doesn't go there. It's decoration anyway. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. So as you can see, the doors are still shut. So really, I don't have to continually shut the doors right now, but or the gates. But I tell you, it's just a really a pain in the neck if you forget and leave them open. So I get obsessive about it. Oh, goodness. Quit carrying that cheese on your head. There we go. Okay. There's Daisy and Thumper. And look at that, we got a duck feather. That's cool. Lucy. Little. Got another egg. Hi, Tyra. And down here we got some wool that came from the bunny rabbit. So the bunny rabbit gives us rabbit's feet and wool. So if we had not gotten that free piece of wool that someone had sent us, and was it Emily? I don't remember who now. We would be getting it just now. So that's kind of cool. Hopefully we'll get a rabbit's foot soon, because that's what we need for the community center. That's one thing. That's the reason we got the bunny. And as I was walking out, I left an egg. Oh my goodness. So, the animals are locked in. They can't get out because their doors are shut. But we're going to rectify that situation ASAP. Put our stuff away. We've got so much stuff. Oh my gosh. Wool can be used for all kinds of things. Sewing is one of them. And we'll hopefully get into that someday. But right now it's like, what can I sell? I wanted to check that duck feather. We had one before. Thought maybe I'm going to hang on to that. We're going to hang on to that first piece of wool. We've got a geode to process. We've got that thing, that chicken statue, which I don't know, we can put it anywhere. Really, it can be outside the chicken coop. It's kind of what makes sense to me. So many things on my mind. So again, you can see it's open right now, and as long as you don't have their big door open, you're fine. I was looking to decide where to put that chicken statue. Man, we got a lot of work to do, but that's okay. It's good kind of work, right? I mean, if you're a farmer, you're working from sun up to sundown. Apparently some of you even more than that. Well, let's see. What are we going to do? Oh, look there. Are you glad that we remembered to bring our hoe? So we could get some free clay. Free clay. I swear, it just doesn't seem like there's many artifact spots or little wormies. Maybe I just don't see them, or they're hidden in the grass. I mean, I don't know. I don't have very good eyesight anyway. And I think that sometimes I just don't see it, because it seems like there is a fraction of the wormies, aka artifact spots, than there are, I think. Squid kids, we're not going in the mines for a while, so sorry. Let's go see how to hide a Pierre. Yeah, well, we're going to try to help. I buy all my seeds from you, man. What do you expect? So, remember that grass starter I mentioned? That recipe is 1,000. So now I decided to cough up the 1,000 because I can make my own grass starter. And the purpose of that, let's go in and see our boyfriend. Let's go see our boyfriend. The purpose of that is to be able to make my own grass starter. We'll see that in a minute. Oh, thanks, Harvey. Appreciate that. And let's look at the relationship. We've got 8 hearts still. Got 2 more hearts to go on him until we can marry him. So we're working on it. So now let's take a look at the calendar again. And the next person's birthday is Lewis, which is in 2 days. So we need to remember this. We need to get something for Lewis. We don't want to forget. Lewis. Okay, let's head on back home with our nice $1,000 recipe that we had to buy. I hate it that we had to spend that much, but in the long run, this is going to save us a bunch of money. So let me show you what you need to craft grass starter. Fiber. Remember I said that? So we are going to be able to craft fiber. So I first start with 100. And then we check and see. It takes 10 fiber to make one. So I was like, okay, that's only 10 pieces of grass. So we need a lot more, because what I'm going to be doing is putting grass in both sides of our little fenced-in area. And see, now I have grass starter. And so how this works is you plant it, and then it will propagate itself if left alone. So I don't have to completely fill an area in for it to grow. As you can see, I'm just kind of putting it around various locations, kind of sparsely. It's like a little here, a little there. I'm trying to stick to about half of what I had grown, but I don't really have to. This side is the one I'm going to leave open for them, so I want more grass over here. So I'm putting the majority, you know, instead of half and half, I'm doing a little more. Plus this side's a little bit bigger. And so, as you can see, I'm really putting a lot of grass in here. And that's from fiber. So it doesn't cost us anything to make it. It costs us 1,000 for the recipe, but that's okay. Now I'm opening up the doors and you can see them. They're all excited about coming out. Look at this. They're like, hello, come on out. And look at them marching over there, and they're happy. Look at them. Come on out here. And I'm going to sneak out this side. Unfortunately, it looks like our goat got stuck going back and forth. And this is when I realized this, we might be having a problem here. I didn't quite build it like I should have. And I'll fix that later. But I'm trying to bump Nanny to turn the right direction, because you can see the other ones are down there just chowing away. They're happy little campers. And I thought, where am I going to put this chicken statue? And I thought, hey, can I? And I could stick it around the other side over there. Again, it's not a necessity, it's just a decoration. I mean, it isn't like you have a cow statue or anything, so whatever. Oh, come on, Nanny, get on over there and get some hay or some fresh grass. But I do shut that up, and I will fix this later, so it's way more convenient than it is. But I was really bummed that Nanny wasn't doing anything, so you go eat, Nanny. Or go back inside, get the hay off the bench. I don't care. So anyway, now you can see why fiber is so crucial. We need a ton of it, and it's okay. I will eventually grow some. So I always have grass starter in my supply. So anyway, that was kind of it was a big turning point, that now my animals can go outside. It is the 5th of spring, but they will be able to be outside from now until wintertime. So I'm very happy about that. What I'm doing here is looking at the other areas and trying to decide where I want to add some more crops, which side. So that's what I'm doing. And I was also checking to see, okay, I wonder if I've got enough scarecrows around. Probably not. But anyways, I'm going to clear some more area here and go ahead and add, and so I can put some more crops. I mean, it takes time to plant. It takes time for harvesting. I'm just not sure. I'm going to get that grass out of my way, because again, grass slows you down. Pathways even speed you up, even more so than walking on just a regular old dirt. So it's another reason to keep those, you know, get those pathways put down as soon as you can. And I'm watching my fiber stack up. It's like, yes. And I was thinking about the community center, and so that popped into my head. It's like, what else do I need? And I did go ahead and check when and where I can get those fish. I was looking at the bulletin board. I need a duck feather, a sunflower, and a red cabbage. Red cabbage, I believe, is not available until summer. So I've got to wait till summer to get that. Hopefully I can get everything else done. I don't know if I did everything I needed for fall. I need to fry an egg. I need a truffle, which is available from a pig, which we don't have because we don't have a big enough building. So we have some work to do in the next couple of months, quite a bit of work, but we'll get there. No worries. We're going to get a rabbit foot eventually and be able to finish that bundle. So, you know, looking at it, it's getting closer and closer. Thought I'd take a quick look in the bat cave, but we got a couple things. Maybe it's been 3 days. I don't know. Honestly, don't know if it's one per day. I just no clue. And it doesn't matter. I just pop in there when I think of it. So it looks like our fruit bin has really got a lot of stuff in it. And I was thinking, where do these blackberry goes? I think they're in the fall and we need to get that changed. We need to move that chest. I'm sorry. Because I want a spring, summer, and fall. I want them in a row and the winter one. So I need to get on that. We will get on that. Don't worry. We only got one task, which is a skull key. I think that we're not ready for that yet. We haven't come across whatever we need to do to get the skull key. Again, you can just feel around and figure these things out on your own, or you can look them up yourself on the wiki if you want to speed things along a little bit. So I did kind of research what do I need for that, and I'm not ready yet. So not spoiling, just saying I'm not ready yet. And I was kind of taking a look down here. It's like, okay, maybe we should clean some of this area up. This area here, I've got something in mind for these. I'll wait until we get there so that you can be surprised. Unless you look at my plan. That's on my 11-year farm, because that's pretty much, I'm going to do the same thing here. Thought I'd go ahead and clean this up while I'm here. And you can see it's 5:40 p.m. All my animals are going back into their respective buildings, except for one. Nanny seems to be stuck, so it's like, there, that bumped her. You can see that it's just, the area is not big enough. That's what I'm looking at, thinking, okay, something's not right. So I kept looking at my plan, thinking, this is not right, I need to fix this, and I will. But anyway, got them outside finally on day 5, and so let's kind of clean up some of this area here. Oh, we keep getting these secret notes. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited about the little secret notes. What's this one say? Oh, another treasure hunt of some kind. Again, I don't, you know, you find out later. You can look those up too on the wiki if you don't want to figure it out yourself. So it's kind of cool. And these little secret surprises. I love surprises. It's like getting a surprise in the mail. So it's fun. Again, I'm just kind of cleaning up here. I haven't decided yet on where I'm going to put my next crops. But it's like, okay, I need to make sure I've got my scarecrows in the proper places. I know they take, you know, they cover 8 different squares around them, I think. But if they're not out there at all, then they're not doing any good, right? So there's my 2 special ones. I'll get 3 special ones, I guess. Eventually you end up with 8 special ones, and that's kind of a fun thing to collect all of them, and I will. And if you don't have them at all, that's fine. You can craft your own, however many you need. Obviously got way more than I need. So get that grass out of my way. Much better. I've always made that spot next to my house kind of a crafting place. What I'm doing is all these things that are like on that block walking, I'm cleaning them up, like the stone and the logs. And I thought I'd move this, get rid of this tree, because I'm really thinking about how I need to redo this fenced area so it makes it much easier for my animals to get around. And again, it's resources, so I'll take the resources. I'm trying not to cut any grass down because I don't know where I'm going to, how I'm going to redo this fence area. It's like, okay, I can't see what I'm doing. It'd be nice if you can hit the right spot. So I'm cleaning all this stuff up. This is a good use of my time. because I'm going to be needing this stuff cleared right away anyways. So, it's like, okay, hit those rocks. And take down some more trees so we can see what we're doing. It's like, oh, there we go. Now we can see. Yeah, we need that stone for our walkways, which we're going to need a lot more of those. Eventually, there'll be walkways all around this farm as we expand and add on more things. And it's kind of fun laying your farm out. You really make it your own, because, I mean, I did a screenshot of when we first started this playthrough on day one of what this farm looked like when we walked off the bus. So I'll do some comparisons as we continue on and show you, because I'm taking some screenshots as we go. You're not seeing them, but I will, and I'll show you what it looks like, what our farm looked like as it continued to change. So that's kind of cool. Get that stone there. Get that stone. I've seen some beautiful designs for Grandpa's shrine, and so we'll have to decide how we want that to look and what we want to put around it. Again, if it wasn't for Grandpa, we would still be in that horrendous cubicle in the big city, and we would be very unhappy about it. So it's awful. There, I put a gate on the bottom here so that if I happen to be down here and I want to go in to that area for any reason, I have a much easier time getting in. And I probably need to put it on the other side too. So that, for now, just that felt like I had done some good work, got some good progress. We're getting there. Nothing really close to where we need to be, but it's okay. It's a never-ending process. You know, we're always going to be changing and... I think I'm still changing my 11-year farm in some respects. Some things it's like, okay, that's exactly how I want it. And other ones is like, I really think I want to edit this or change this. So that's cool. You can. It takes a little work, but you can. So I'm just trying to make sure that I don't get it to a point where I hate it or there's something that's really off. And that's one thing I'm using my pattern for, is to say, okay, I want to make sure I don't do that again. So now it's getting late on day 5. Look at that. It's midnight already. Can you believe it? Doesn't feel like it's midnight already. And let's see. Looks like we're going to get 1800 and or 1900 for the work. Yeah, blackberry jelly is 90. It's not the greatest, but it's better than zero. And that's getting us there slowly but surely. It's day 6 of spring and year number 2. Let's get up and get moving. And still don't have any more quests on my journal. That's okay. Let's check the weather for tomorrow. It's going to be sunny tomorrow. Okay. Okay. So we got some mail. Let's see what we got. Clint is sending us an iron bar. Thanks, Clint. Appreciate that. We need that. And Emily wants a fresh apricot. And it just so happens, because of our bat cave, we have one. That's awesome that we have one, because otherwise we wouldn't have one for like 2 years or 3 years. So I would thought that's pretty cool. Yes, we accepted the quest. We'll take it. And there's our one apricot. Hopefully we'll be getting some more, because that's the only one we have. So we're going to pet our key cat. Hey there, Furball, get you some water. Check the silo, 188, it's doing great. We just need to make sure that by the fall, however many animals we have, that thing, by the way, was empty. It was an empty capsule. So I had looked it up and thought, what the heck? It's a weird little thing that happened, so anyway. I lost my train of thought. That happens. Senior moments, lots of times. Okay, so what I do is I just do my right mouse button and then go over all of the animals, oops, in the area. But don't do the door. It's so easy to do that to the door. I've actually broken a door before by opening and shutting it too many times. I just want to make sure I had petted everyone. Now I'm going to milk our cow and milk our goat. And there we go. We got everything we need. So now we get to go in the buildings. Yeah, let's see. We still got an egg that's in the incubator. I can't remember what it is. But look at this. Look. We have another dinosaur egg. So, we could take it to Gunther or not. We're not ready to take it to Gunther. If the museum was like almost full, then I would have a dilemma on what to do. But it's not almost full. So we're going to keep propagating some dinosaurs because the dinosaur mayonnaise is like the most expensive mayonnaise there is. Expensive. The most, you get the most money for it. I'm not, my words are losing me. So I thought that I wanted to tell you dinosaurs, dinosaurs, dinosaurs. So I love the other animals. I really do. But the dinosaurs, I mean, they're quiet. They don't make squawking noises or pig noises, and you get the mayonnaise they make is very valuable. So you can see they're pretty much eating all that grass. It may be gone by the end of the day, so I'm gonna have to really figure this out soon. So for now, we've got a couple things that we can put in our shipping bin, and I've got an apricot for whoever it was that asked for it. Not too sure what to do about that broken capsule that's now empty. It has some weird event that happens with it. It's real minimal. I thought, okay, that seems kind of strange. But again, it's something different. It's something weird and something, it's not like everyday ho-hum. You can get into a rut, but if there's other things going on, then it's fun, right? So first thing we're going to do is go see our buddy Clint and ask him to pop our geode that we found. See if we get anything good. You never know. First off, let's go talk to the poor guy. We hardly ever speak to him. But if we do every time that we come in, then it'll help the relationship there. So he's one of those people that we don't talk to enough. And Orpiment, we've already got one, so that's okay. Now, we need to go up here and get this, what is it, a daffodil. We'll pick up the daffodils. Oh, and who shall we see but our handsome boyfriend? Hello there, Harvey. You feel old. More memories you're burdened with. Aw, don't be sad here. You're welcome. Let's see. Still got 8 hearts, but that's okay. We can't give him any more gifts this week. I don't know when the week changes. Hardwood ectoplasm not happening. Well, looky there. Go down here and say hello to Kent. Hello, Kent. Okay, and he seems a friendly sort. I mean, he's not rude or anything to start off with or anything. You know, as opposed to Shane, go away. Thanks, Shane. And I'm checking the houses to make sure I'm going in the right one. And let's see, there's Haley. Well, hello there, Emily. And her, look at this, she's got all kinds of sewing stuff. She says she really wants to be a seamstress, so that's interesting. Fresh fruit. Bring Emily an apricot, and we can bring her an apricot. There we go. And that helps our relationship with Emily. And she paid us $600. Oh my gosh, thank you so much. We need that money so bad. Whew. We've got a long way to go. Oh my goodness. We need over $15,000 more than we have right now to upgrade our building, and we still need things in between then, so oh my goodness. We have a long way to go, people, but we could do this. We can do this. We're gonna get that community center done by the end of this year. You just watch. Keep watching. Stay tuned. No guarantees. All right. Look at all this. We really need to clean this up right here because it's such a pain in the neck to come in from the south and everything's kind of blocking our way. And we're eventually going to be putting things there anyway. Still haven't decided how many more crops we're going to plant. I know I need to do a lot more refined quartz. Put that away. We only had one of those, so I'm going to get a second one. And I'm going to really keep an eye on that stash. And if there's any of them more than 5, I'm going to start getting rid of them and selling them because we need that money. So it's noon, and I'm looking at the ore situation, and we have got to go get more iron ore Oh, because if we end up needing it, we're just so low on it. I was comparing these two swords again, and that Obsidian Edge to me is still better because of the damage that it does. It does so much more damage, so I'm gonna stick with it, and I'll probably keep that one until we find the next best thing. But it's a level 6, the other one's a level 5, and I probably should take it to the Adventurers Guild and sell it. I don't see myself using it. So I grab a couple of bombs, which I already had, and some cave carrots. And you might want to take your pickaxe, Dodo Head, because you can't break open stones with a hoe. Started to go the other way and realized, oh, wait, I got the mine cart. It's been so long since we've actually been in the mine, we forgot. So let's get up there and get busy. Maybe we'll get lucky again. Remember the last time we went for copper, we ended up with over 100 copper in like 5 levels. It was incredible. So it's like, okay. The only thing, I hesitated there for a second. I thought about going to the quarry, but I wanted to make sure that I'm going to levels that have specifically iron ore. And look at this. What a great decision that was. Look at this pile of ore over here. Thinking, okay, here you bombers, look at me. Look at me using my bomb. Look at that. And we ended up with 11 iron ore. That is awesome. Better start collecting those quartz, as obviously we're gonna need some. Moving stuff down so I can see. I wanna see how much iron ore I'm getting, so everything else goes down below. And let's get to it. That first one was pretty awesome. And here's some more over here. I don't know what creatures we're gonna run into anymore. I forget what, it's been so long since we've been here. Oh, those weird little black bouncy furball things. I don't know what they are. All I know is that you don't want them to get too close to you. Man, that one gave us a frozen tear and coal and stone and all kinds of goodies. Let me go get this other one so he doesn't get up, come up behind me. And looks like there's one more piece of iron ore here. Well, actually 3 pieces. So in the meantime, we're just kind of look for some stairs. I got an Omni Geode. Cool. We haven't got too many of those lately. They're supposed to be so rare, and I guess they are. Yeah, let's see. All right, starting off pretty good here. What do we got so far? We're up to 20 ore, and look at this level. Oh my goodness, we got a whole bunch on level 43. So we're gonna kill these things so they don't sneak up on us like that. Hate those things. And those, ugh. Bats aren't too hard because you can keep them ahead of you. Slimes jump behind you. Look at all these ores. My goodness. So I suppose if I decided I wanted to make bombs, I guess I could have bombed this whole place, but instead, no big deal. This is how I do it. When I only have, I don't think I've only made like 2 bombs ever. I have to look next time I craft something and see. And that gives another topaz. I'm not sure how many we have. But I really am gonna start cutting down on how many we keep, just because they're mostly used for quest items, and I don't know what else they're used for. And I figure if I keep 5 of everything, then anything else should be fair game to sell. That's what I'm thinking. So hopefully my thinking is okay. Not sure. Well, I don't see any stairs, so we're just gonna have to start hacking around trying to find some. So generally, what I'll do is I'll find like a nook where I can stand in one place and hit like 4 or 5 at the, and then usually I'll end up with stairs like that. It's like, uh-oh. Okay, oh, he got me before I could get back. I was trying to back up. He got me before I could back up. Man, looks like, oh, there's some good ore here too. So good. Good, 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 good. And we haven't used any food. We have, our health is still almost near the top. Our energy is, I've got probably 3/4 of the original energy that I had. So it looks like there's all kinds of ore here. This is good. Oh, we're up over 50 now. That's awesome. Yeah, let's see. Get rid of these slimes. Oh, we've got a whole bunch of little black furbally things. I don't know what those things are. Isn't that interesting that there is a stone that was down below? I don't know why that happened. So get rid of these guys. They give us some coal and a few other items occasionally. I just want to him to. Oh, I see what was happening. He was on the other side of the stairs. Look at that. 2 stairs at the same place. Isn't that weird? I don't know if it's just an extra lucky day or what. I didn't look. At this point, I honestly don't care. It's more about my convenience than it is luck and thinking, oh, well, I'm not going to go today because there's no luck. I'm not doing that. This is more my convenience. I had time. We needed the ore. We're going to go. So, you know, best use of my time. No idea. And I don't care. That's what I needed to do today. Okay, it looks like I've been around the whole room, so I don't see any more obvious iron ore nodes. That doesn't mean there isn't any here, it just means I'm not seeing any. So in hitting the pieces that are left, you know, you'll occasionally find it, but I'm really just looking for stairs. Stairs, stairs, stairs. Oh, I got a frozen geode. Look at that, out of a plain old stone. How about that? Awesome. Gotta be stairs somewhere. In the meantime, we're getting stone, which we're using for our pathways anyway, so that's good. We'll use it. And plus, we're gonna need it for a building, so. Oh, whoa, look at this. Oh my. Wonder if I can get far enough back. I'm not very good with this since I don't do bombs very often. And just before I got ready to start on it, we're getting an infestation, but I'm thinking, I don't care. There we go. Look at all that. Oh my goodness. 17 ore in one spot. So yes, yes, yes. And we don't care about the bats. Eventually we'll hit enough bats that we get some kind of reward from Gil at the Adventurer's Guild. I think that's what it's called, the Adventurer's Guild. I think that's what it's called. So anyway, we don't care. We'll just kill them. It's fine. We'll take your bat wings because we need them for something and I don't remember what it is. Thought I'd better run up here before I go down the stairs and see if there's any more iron ore nodes because there were so many down below. There might be another stash up here if I can get past all these annoyances. Like you, Mr. Slime. And there's another one. So that's good. That was good we came up here. Wow, we got 4 with one hit. So that was nice. This is a good run. How many we got so far? We got 73 iron ore so far. So this has been another good run. Taking us a little longer. We started on level 40 and we're on 46. But look at this. I mean, this is really working out pretty well. Another frozen Gia, or frozen tier, I'm sorry. And another 3 ore. So man, that is awesome. We're almost 80 so far. That is so awesome. Keep going. There we go. All right. Let's see about this one here. There's one. And what is it? It's 9:50. It's getting kind of late. Oh, we got 4 on that one. That was good. And that took us up over 80. Be awesome if we could leave at 100 or so, like we did the copper. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything here that I'm seeing. I decided it's late enough. Let's go. We'll take our 80 copper, our 80 iron ore, and head for home. I was very happy with that. So you know, if we could just do that once in a while, we'll stay in the supply that we need. For the whatever we're crafting, because you can see we're not crafting a whole bunch of stuff anyway, but when I am, I need the stuff. Let's see, that gave us 6 topaz, and we've got 12 frozen tears, is that what they're called? Yeah, we've got so many of those. I think I'm going to take that supply down to 5, the topaz down to 5. We're going to keep the earth crystals, and we're going to keep the yeah, what that one was, because we need those for crafting things. And so the other things I don't think we need for crafting, so we need the money more, so we are going to sell anything over 5 for now. If we find out later we're like need something for crafting, then we'll change our other mind. Don't forget to put slime away. And let's see, put our sword away and our cave carrot that we didn't eat away. Get those up there on the bar where I can see them so we can take them to Clint. And we'll go sell these other ones, and that will help us significantly, hopefully. I don't know how much they sell for. But there we go. That's not a bad day. Day 6 of spring in year number 1. putting away everything and then gathering things that I'm going to need for tomorrow. Taking a look down below, looking at how things are growing. I'm happy with all of that. That's all cauliflower. And once we start processing that, holy moly, that's going to be a good thing. During the night, something weird happens. A witch flies over the chicken coop. What could that possibly mean? Oh my goodness. We'll have to find out next time. Thank you for following me along on this journey. If you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. That helps me feel validated. Plus, it makes the YouTube like me a lot better. If you like my video, please give that a like. That also helps. But the most important thing, really, is I want you to have a wonderful rest of your day.